Welcome to the Advanced Teaching series where we'll go through common workflow exercises and super team features that will help get you up to speed in no time. In this video, we'll show you how easy it is to insert a railing on concrete stairs in Advanced Steel. Here is an example project where we would like to create some concrete stairs and insert a railing on the top of them. Advanced Steel offers dedicated tools to create concrete elements. You can insert a concrete beam between two points, just like you insert a steel beam. Within the Properties dialog box, it is easy to modify its size by clicking inside the cell, as it is a parametric section. You can change the visual style to 2D wireframe to better see the reference lines previously inserted outside of this movie to speed up the creation of the first thread. Dedicated tools are available in the Advanced Steel tool palette to move and rotate the UCS in order to have the XY plane vertical and in the plane of the construction lines. You can use the polygonal control command available in the Features tab to create a polygonal cut for the first thread by picking the three points, defining the triangular cut to be applied on the concrete beam. Once the first triangular beam created, it can be copied to create the subsequent threads by using the Advanced Steel Copy command. You just need to pick graphically the points and enter the quantity of required copies. To adjust the bottom of the concrete stairs, you can go back to the same tools as previously used to position and rotate the UCS as necessary. Then the shorten at UCS command can be applied one time on the horizontal plane and one time on the vertical plane to create the cuts at the end of the concrete beam. Before creating the upper concrete landing, you can access the management tools and modify the disable the feature option so that concrete elements do not join automatically when inserting them in the 3D model. You can use the miter command available in the tool palette to join the two concrete sections together. You can complete the upper landing by inserting an additional concrete slab and easily change its size afterwards. Now you can use the automatic railing macro to insert a railing on the top of the concrete stairs by picking a start point and an end point. In the properties dialog box which shows up, you can set the railing to the left and choose among various possibilities for the post connection. It is easy to specify the right values thanks to the explicit pictures which are displayed on the right of the dialog. If we zoom to the intermediate landing, you can see that small portions of horizontal tube are already in place. You can use in this case a specific automatic connection to connect it with the rail of the sloped railing by inserting an elbow. You can use the Advanced Steel Create by Template command to replicate the connection from the top end rail to the middle end rail. You can use the navigation tools like Orbit, Zoom and Pan to move around the concrete stairs. This concludes the exercise. Feel free to try these steps on your own Advanced Steel designs.